know that breakfast is the most important meal of the day. In fact, you have to eat within 40 minutes of waking up to get your metabolism going. But I tell you what, toast and cereal can get a little bit boring. But luckily, we have the gorgeous Alina, MasterChef winner for 2016, with us today. She's showing us how to whip up a few gourmet breakfast ideas. Alina, let's start with this amazing bread that you made.
Okay, so not only are these delicious, they're really good for you. So the bread that I made to bring in today is a grain-free, gluten-free, sugar-free.
It's so dense.
It is so dense. So you need a lot less of it to enjoy. And we're going to do, I mean, smashed avocado is on every menu at the moment.
Yeah.
So we're going to...
This is all breakfast, isn't it? Is it easy to prepare breakfast beforehand?
Well, this I make at the beginning of the week, and I put it, I slice it, put it in the freezer, take slices out as I need it, so it can last longer than that if you wish. But definitely a good breakfast is about being prepared. So if you do all of this at the beginning of the week, you're sorted for the rest of the week.
Noticed you preparing this avocado, and you were really interesting. You've sliced it all along.
I have sliced it all along there. I'm going to put a little bit of this labneh on.
Now, explain to us what the labneh is. This is really interesting.
Labneh is a hung yogurt. So
and you can do it yourself at home.
You can absolutely do it yourself at home.
A hung yogurt.
So you hang it in muslin?
Yep,
and muslin. And you let the whey drip through?
You
and then you're left with the curd.
Yeah, so it's a protein rich. And then we've got the avocado here that we've sliced, so we're going to scoop it out with
is
all of those.
Is this smashed avocado? Look, because we'd like to buy a house eventually.
What a clever idea.
So we're going to just... Oh, we've made a little bit of a mess.
Oh, gee, that looks really fancy, doesn't it?
Well, this is the point. Like, if stuff looks nice, you tend to want to eat it more.
Is that okay to eat it sort of a half an avocado like that? Is that...
Absolutely. It's all good fats. All good fats. And then we've also got here a spiced dukka.
Oh,
so you're not going to miss the sugar if you've got lots of other flavours and textures.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a dukka that I made
last
night. Wow. Make it myself.
But you can buy it.
Dukka is a Middle Eastern spices. And so what's in yours? You've got...
So I've got pumpkin seeds, sesame seeds, almonds, turmeric, ginger, lemon myrtle, an Australian native. So lots of different flavours, and you can make it your own. You put the flavours in there that you like.
And you can buy it at the...
You can buy it. You can buy it. It's quite expensive to buy, I find.
But you don't use a lot of it.
No. You don't use a lot of it, but it also lasts because it's dry. Mm. There's nothing that's going to go off in there.
You put some double virgin olive oil in it?
A little bit of olive oil in
there.
Excellent. So there's one.
Okay, this one.
The next one is a chia pudding, which is about 50, one can of coconut milk, about 50 grams of chia seeds.
What is chia?
Chia seed is a protein-rich seed which expands with liquid. We've also got vanilla bean in there. So that's as easy as it is.
Mm-hmm.
It will become a pudding-like consistency in about 4 hours, or you can leave it overnight for an easy breakfast. So that is your chia pudding there. So scooping that in for our breakfast. Might just get a lot of that in there.
So it really thickens up, doesn't it?
Absolutely. And we're going to put some fresh blueberries in there.
Mm-hmm.
So all of these...
Come back.
Thank you for catching. All of these are sugar-free options. And
cherries?
Refined sugar-free. There's a little bit of fruit sugar in here.
And same with strawberries are brilliant as well, aren't they, for
berries
a low sugar?
Berries are definitely the better option for low sugar fruits. So we've... easily then got another breakfast option.
What do you put here?
Pudding?
Some coconut.
Some more coconut.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So these are all sugar free. I'm participating in Feb Fast, and I'm giving up sugar for all of February.
Wow.
So
it's so hard to avoid it though, isn't it? It's in everything.
Not
it's
if
in
you
everything
cook your
from
own food.
But what if like even yogurts and low fat yogurts and things like that,
I
they
would
tend
go
to
for
amp
a Greek
up the sugar.
Yeah,
okay.
I'd go for a natural or a Greek. So this is dairy free as well. So these last two are dairy free.
Mm-hmm.
So this is a coconut yogurt, which is also really gorgeous.
Mm.
And you buy coconut yogurt?
You can buy it, and there's quite a few available now. There was, for a little while, there was only sort of one or two brands on the market.
I didn't even know there was such a thing.
Now, this is a homemade granola again. I've prepared all of this on a Sunday, and then I'm set for the week.
How do you make your own granola?
Mm. Okay, so I've taken a kilo of my favourite nuts, seeds, and dried fruit.
Mm-hmm.
Dried fruit to a minimum. I'm trying to avoid the sugar. A teaspoon of, well, actually probably a tablespoon of cinnamon and cocoa and 100 grams of coconut oil, and then in the oven at 80 degrees for about 4 hours.
Very slow cooking.
Very slow cooking, whichever
berries really nice.
You like. Mm. Very satisfying textures and flavours. And if we want, we can put some passion fruit on there too, because it looks so good.
I love a bit of brekkie. Best meal of the day. That looks sensational. So we've got the
three breakfasts.
Avo on toast.
Under 5 minutes.
Pudding.
Because you've done your prep on the weekend.
And fancy cereal.
Sugar-free, gluten-free, grain-free. And 2 out of 3 are dairy-free.
We love it. We will put all the details on our Facebook page, so make sure you check it out. You're so clever.